Second day of India-Pakistan delegation-level talks on the Indus Water Treaty. The two-day water talks began in Pakistani city of Lahore on Wednesday, and sources tell WION that India has taken a tough position. Indian delegation has told Pakistani delegation that India itself has water shortages due to climate change and that Pakistan also does not have new dams to store water. This is the first bilateral engagement between two countries since Imran Khan took over as the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Now, Indus Water Commissioner P.K. Saxena is representing India in the two-day talks in Pakistan. The last meeting of the Pakistan-India Permanent Indus Commission was held in New Delhi in March this year. Now, Nepal is holding the fourth summit of the BIMSTEC, or the Bay of Bengal Initiative for the Multi-Sectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. Addressing the summit, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi made a number of announcements to bring the BIMSTEC nation closer, making a pitch for the neighborhood first. He said India is ready to host a BIMSTEC startup conclave and strengthen transport links between these nations. He also invited BIMSTEC nations to Mobile Congress in Delhi and the Buddhist conclave in August 2020. He also offered scholarship for 30 students from these countries. The two-day summit is focusing on trade connectivity and counter-terrorism.
Science and technology, हमारे entrepreneurs के बीच संपर्क और कनेक्टिविटी बढ़ाने के लिए भारत BIMSTEC स्टार्टअप कॉन्क्लेव होस्ट करने के लिए तैयार है. मैं आशा करता हूं कि सभी BIMSTEC देश इस वर्ष अक्टूबर में नई दिल्ली में आयोजित की जा रही इंडिया मोबाइल कांग्रेस में भागीदार होंगे. इस कांग्रेस में BIMSTEC मिनिस्टरियल कॉन्क्लेव भी शामिल है.
And I'm joined by my colleague, Siddhant Sibyl, live from Kathmandu. Siddhant, just take us through the important highlights of the day.
Well, the first day of the BIMSTEC summit is over here in Kathmandu. The plenary just got over half an hour ago. And in that, the Indian Prime Minister announced a slew of measures trying to reinvigorate the grouping, which is having its fourth summit in just 21 years. That is a long period, and just four summits. So he basically announced how startups can meet, how ministers can come for the Buddhist conclave in 2020 and other such initiatives, so that there is more dialogue. There is more talk between the BIMSTEC leaders. But one thing that came out was from the speech of the Nepal's Prime Minister. He said about SAARC, talking about SAARC on a BIMSTEC platform is of course something which everyone took note. He said that SAARC and BIMSTEC complement each other. They don't substitute each other. That's an important statement made by the Nepali Prime Minister. But all in all, if we look at the speeches made by all the leaders, it was all about connectivity and how connectivity can be increased. And shortly, the Foreign Secretary will be arriving here at the location where I am standing and will brief the media about what transpired. And other than that, about the bilaterals also, the bilateral with the Sri Lankan President and with the Bangladeshi Prime Minister.
So what's the outlook tomorrow, in context of India? What are the important outlines we should be looking forward to, Siddhant?
Well, tomorrow, the second day of the BIMSTEC summit, the Kathmandu Declaration will be adopted, and a key point that will be taken will be the connectivity. All the leaders talked about connectivity, but tomorrow the groundwork will be laid when it comes to how all these countries can connect with each other. But other than that, important thing that's going to take place, that the Indian Prime Minister is going to hand over a Dharamshala, which he announced in 2014 during his maiden visit to Nepal, to the Nepali Prime Minister, built at the cost of 25 crore rupees. This Dharamshala is near the Pashupatinath temple, an important temple not only for Hindus in Nepal but across the world, especially in India, where a lot of people come to visit this place. So that will be a resting place for people who come here, a 400 bed Dharamshala, a gift from the people of India to the people of Nepal.
Thank you so much for joining me from Kathmandu, Siddhant.